Have Sabbath. We are happy to be back here to continue our series. For those that are visiting us, we have the creation study group, the third Sabbath of every month, and we are going through a series about history of education. And we've been talking about the education from Eden to heaven. And Marcela have addressed many parts. Should do a quick review and introduce a topic that addresses the modern system of education.
Então, hoje nós vamos finalizar uma série que nós falamos sobre o tema, o conceito de educação.
So, we are going to go to the final part of a series where we're talking about the topic of education.
Nós vimos que na Bíblia nós podemos encontrar modelos de educação, de como Deus trabalhou a educação do seu povo.
We could see that in the Bible we can find models about the educational system and how God works with his own people.
Quem aqui estava nos encontros passados quando eu falei sobre esses modelos?
Who was here in any of the previous meetings when she was talking about these educational models?
Ninguém aqui estava? É novidade para todo mundo?
Is it new for everyone? Okay.
Okay, então eu vou explanar rapidamente.
So I'm gonna go briefly through it.
No modelo do Éden,
in the Eden's model,
a escola era um jardim que Deus criou.
The school was at the garden.
A própria natureza, onde Adão e Eva moravam.
So in the nature where Adam and Eve were living in.
O professor, a autoridade maior, o professor era o próprio Deus.
The biggest authority was the teacher, that in that case was God.
E os alunos, Adão e Eva.
And the students were Adam and Eve.
E os compêndios, os materiais didáticos de ensino de Deus.
And the educational materials, the compendiums that were used by this teacher, God,
eram a natureza,
were nature,
o trabalho útil,
useful work,
as experiências da vida,
life experiences,
e a própria palavra de Deus.
And the word of God itself.
Na natureza,
in nature,
Adão e Eva poderiam aprender observando.
Through nature, Adam and Eve could learn by observation.
As leis, as operações.
They could learn by observing the laws, the operations in nature.
E os princípios que governam as leis do universo.
And also observing the principles that govern the functioning of the universe.
Adão e Eva também receberam trabalho no jardim.
Adam and Eve also received some work to be done.
Eles precisavam cultivar e cuidar do jardim.
They were supposed to cultivate the garden.
Cultivar a natureza.
They should cultivate and take care of nature.
E cuidar dos animais também.
And they also should take care of the animals.
Cuidar da vida na Terra.
They should take care of life in this planet.
E eles também poderiam aprender pelas experiências de vida através da instrução e conselhos que eles tinham com dos anjos, os outros seres também.
They also could learn from life experiences through the devices that they were receiving from God's angels.
Além de ter o privilégio de ter contato face a face com Deus e ter a sua palavra diretamente.
And they also have the privilege of having, they also could learn from the privilege of having face-to-face contact with God.
Com a entrada do pecado.
But when sin entered in this planet,
nós percebemos que o povo de Deus se afastou muito dos princípios e do ideal da criação.
And we could see that God's people, they depart from the ideal scenario and the principles of education.
E Deus vai trabalhando a educação desse seu povo através das famílias, no modelo patriarcal.
And then God starts to work the educational model through families in the period of the patriarchs.
Então as crianças cresciam no lar.
So the kids were they were growing at home.
No meio da família onde os maiores professores eram os próprios pais.
So they were growing in the midst of their families, where the teachers were their own parents.
Sob a direção de Deus.
Under God's direction.
E também continuavam aprendendo através da natureza.
They also kept learning through nature.
Através do trabalho útil.
They were also learning through useful work.
Essas famílias cultivavam o solo.
They were cultivating, for example,
cuidavam de animais.
Soil, the ground. They were taking care of animals.
Aprendiam através das experiências de vida.
They were also learning through life experiences.
Aquelas histórias das famílias, as experiências com Deus.
For example, they were learning from family stories, from their experiences with God.
E aprendiam também com a própria palavra de Deus, que era transmitida oralmente, de pai para filho.
They also were learning from the word of God that was transmitted from father to son. It was transmitted orally.
O povo de Israel acabou indo morar no Egito. O povo de Israel foi morar no Egito.
Then the people of Israel, they moved to Egypt.
Onde teve contato com uma cultura pagã.
Where they had contact with a pagan culture.
Que influenciou totalmente os seus hábitos e fizeram esse povo esquecer de muitas coisas que eles haviam aprendido sobre Deus.
And
que influenciou
That influenced their habits.
Essa cultura pagã que fez eles esquecerem as coisas que aprenderam.
Pode falar no microfone.
Essa cultura pagã.
This pagan culture.
Que fez eles esquecerem.
Made them to forget.
Os aprendizados com Deus.
All the teachings that they receive from God.
E Deus leva esse povo para o deserto.
And then God bring these people to the desert.
E ali estabelece uma escola também.
And then he establish another school also there in the desert.
Onde ele coloca Moisés como um professor.
And at the desert the teacher was Moses.
Sob a direção de Deus.
Under God's direction.
E o povo que são os estudantes.
And the students are the people of Israel.
Os educandos.
They are the students.
Que passam agora a aprender através da natureza também.
They also start to learn from nature.
Temos a coluna de fogo, o maná.
For example, they have the pillar of fire, the maná, waters.
A água das rochas.
Water from the rocks.
Os ciclos da natureza.
The cycles of nature.
E o próprio deserto com seus perigos.
The desert itself and all the struggles and dangers that exist there.
O trabalho útil sempre esteve presente.
The useful work was always present.
Precisavam construir suas tendas, o santuário.
They were supposed to be building, they need to build their own tents, their houses, they have to build the sanctuary.
Criar os animais e fazerem vários tipos de trabalhos domésticos.
They have to take care of the animals and do several types of errands, houseworks.
As experiências da vida continuam sendo valiosas.
So the life experiences are still valuable in this educational system.
As festas religiosas.
The religious feasts were also important.
As leis de saúde, higiene, que eram importantes na experiência das pessoas.
The health laws and other laws, the religious laws, hygiene were also important.
A convivência social entre todos.
The social life was important also.
E as histórias dos antepassados.
And the stories, the histories of the ancestors from the patriarchs and go back to Eden and Eve were also important.
E a palavra de Deus era uma coisa importante também.
And the word of God was also very important.
Eles receberam os escritos dos 10 mandamentos.
They received the 10 commandments.
As leis cerimoniais e civis e judiciais dadas pelo próprio Deus.
They also received the ceremonial, civil and judicial laws given by God itself through Moses.
Havia os ritos do santuário, os símbolos e os cânticos.
There are also the sanctuary rites. Rites, symbols, chants.
Todos esses elementos eram ensinamentos de Deus.
All these elements were teachings from God.
Depois esse povo se estabelece.
After these people, the people of Israel established themselves in Canaan.
Na terra de Canaã. E eles começam a se afastar novamente dos ensinos de Deus.
So after they established themselves in Canaan, they start to depart again from God.
E o profeta Samuel estabelece uma nova escola.
And then prophet Samuel establishes a new school.
Para resgatar esse povo para o ideal original de Deus aqui na Terra.
To restore the God's ideal for these people.
Que agora é a escola dos profetas.
And now we have the school of prophets.
Os professores nessa escola eram os próprios profetas sob a orientação de Deus.
The teachers in this new educational system were the prophets themselves under God's direction.
Os estudantes eram jovens promissores dentro do povo de Israel.
The students were the promising young people among the people of Israel.
E eles continuavam aprendendo com a natureza.
And they kept learning from nature.
Através do trabalho útil.
They were learning through useful work.
Porque eles trabalhavam na construção e faziam serviços de manutenção dessas escolas.
So, for example, they have manual skills used in construction and service for the maintenance of the school.
Continuavam cultivando aprendizado pelas experiências de vida.
They kept learning through the experiences of life.
E pela palavra de Deus.
And by God's word.
Temos também na Bíblia um modelo da própria educação de Jesus. Jesus.
We also have in the Bible a model based on the education that Jesus himself received.
Jesus pôde viver uma experiência como aluno, como um estudante.
So Jesus had an experience as student
e como professor.
And also as teacher.
Como um educando, ele foi educado pelos seus pais no lar.
As a student, he was educated by his parents.
E como professor, ele educou os discípulos.
And as teacher, he taught the disciples.
E podemos ver que os compêndios de Deus se repetem.
And we can see that the compêndios, the materials, the strategy of God, the model is repeated.
O ensino continuou sendo baseado na natureza.
Because the teaching was still based in nature.
No trabalho útil.
In useful work.
Nas experiências de vida.
In life experiences.
E na palavra de Deus.
And also in the word of God.
Isso dentro da Bíblia.
And all these things we can learn in the Bible.
No livro O Grande Conflito da escritora Ellen White.
But when we go to the book of Ellen G. White called The Great Controversy.
Ela fala sobre a educação dos valdenses.
She talks about the education of the valdenses.
E nós podemos ver também a experiência dos valdenses como crianças, na educação das crianças.
And we can see in their experience with children.
Assim como na educação dos jovens.
And we can see in the experience with children and the young people were similar.
Todos viviam na natureza.
All of them were living in nature.
Nas montanhas.
In the mountains.
Trabalhavam. Também cultivavam trabalho útil.
They also were working, they were developing useful work.
Tinha as atividades domésticas, atividades no campo.
They have domestic activities, errands and other activities. They have activities in the field, in the midst of nature.
Cuidado com os animais e agricultura.
They have to take care of animals, they have to deal with agriculture.
Eles eram preparados especialmente para as experiências da vida.
They were especially prepared for life experiences.
E estudavam com muito cuidado a palavra de Deus.
And they were studying carefully the word of God.
Inclusive as crianças eram ensinadas a memorizar os textos sagrados.
So this was so important that even the children were taught more, they were motivated, they received motivation to memorize the word of God.
E preparadas para quando fossem jovens saíssem em viagens missionárias.
And they were prepared for the time when they, after getting older, when they were young, so they were prepared to be missionaries, to be spread and be preaching the word of God wherever they go.
Esses jovens, eles iam estudar nas universidades.
So these young people from the Valdensians, they were going to the universities.
Eles iam ter um convívio comunitário com outras pessoas.
So they have the opportunity to have social life with other people.
Mas eles estudavam as escrituras e copiavam ainda trechos dos escritos sagrados para distribuir.
So they were studying the scriptures and also making copies of it to be able to share when it was necessary.
Podemos ver também, especialmente baseado na profecia de Daniel,
we also can look to the prophecy of Daniel and see something interesting.
Que houveram alguns impérios que dominaram o mundo.
That there were some empires that controlled the world, where the Bible was existing.
O Império da Babilônia.
We have Babylon.
Grécia.
Greece.
Medo-Pérsia antes da Grécia.
Medo-Pérsia before Greece.
E o Romano.
And Roman Empire.
E nós temos o pé, né, que é uma mistura.
And at the feet of the statue, we have a mix.
Com resquícios do Romano ainda.
A mix, an empire that is mixed, but is divided, but there are pieces that are parts of Rome.
O Império Romano bebeu muito da influência cultural do Império Grego.
The Roman Empire drank from the cultural influence of the Greek Empire.
Ele fez questão de preservar o legado grego na cultura.
And the Roman Empire wanted to maintain the legacy of the Greek.
Então era o pensamento Greek grego people. E romano que dominava na época de Jesus.
So by the time of Jesus was the Greco-Roman thought that was dominating the predominance in the time of Jesus.
E muitos aspectos característicos desse pensamento grego e romano permanecem até os nossos dias.
And many aspects of this Greco-Roman thoughts still exist in our society today.
Muitas filosofias sobre educação foram desenvolvidas nessa época.
Many philosophies about education were developed by this time.
Mas foram desenvolvidas fora do plano de Deus.
But they were developed outside of God's plan.
E essas filosofias ajudaram a despreparar o povo de Deus também.
And these philosophies helped to unprepare God's people.
Despreparar o povo perante a vinda do Messias.
They were developed to unprepare the people to the coming of Christ, to the prophecies.
Por exemplo,
for example,
nós podemos tanto ver na história dos fariseus.
We can see in the history of the Pharisees.
O sistema educacional que existia nessa época, ele era formal.
The educational system they had by that time was very formal.
Com pouca oportunidade para discussão e pensamento independente das pessoas.
Almost no opportunity for discussion and for freedom of thought and discussion.
Ele era baseado na tradição.
So this was a educational system based in tradition.
Que até então tinha tomado o lugar da autoridade das escrituras sagradas.
And by this time, its authority was based in tradition, so it took the authority from the Bible.
E era cheio de conteúdos e informações inúteis.
And it's full of contents and information that is useless for practical life.
Da mesma maneira foi no período da Idade Média.
And the same happened during the period of the Middle Age.
As escolas que eram dominadas pela Igreja Católica.
The schools that were controlled by the Catholic Church.
Trabalhavam fortemente toda essa tradição grega no ensino.
Worked out all this Greek tradition through their educational system.
E nós vamos ver um pouquinho sobre isso.
We are going to check a little bit about it.
A princípio, temos as principais diferenças entre o pensamento hebraico e o pensamento grego.
For example, we have them here table with the main differences between the Hebrew, the biblical thoughts, and the Greek thoughts.
Esses dois tipos de visões de mundo se constituem como uma cosmovisão.
So these two types of views about life, the world, the reality, constitute two different types of cosmovisions or worldviews.
Pensamento hebraico a princípio.
So the Hebrew thought in principle.
Ele está mais ligado ao pensamento, à lógica de como a Bíblia foi escrita.
So the Hebrew thought in principle is more connected to the logic how the Bible was written.
Enquanto o pensamento grego,
while the Greek thought,
ele forma a base do da sociedade ocidental, especialmente.
While the Greek thought is the it forms is the foundation of the Western society.
Especialmente os países que se originaram da história do cristianismo. Tem uma história de cristã.
Especially in the foundation of the history of the countries that were influenced by the Christian world.
No pensamento hebraico, as ideias elas são mais concretas.
So in the Hebrew thought we have a concrete list of ideas.
As pessoas se preocupam com a experiência prática da vida, das coisas.
In the Hebrew thought people are concerned on practical experiences in life.
As pessoas descrevem as coisas no mundo com objetos e conceitos tendo a ver com coisas concretas.
So people describe things and objects that have to do with reality.
No pensamento grego, as ideias elas são mais metafísicas.
In the Greek thoughts, the ideas are more metaphysical.
As coisas e as relações humanas são descrevidas com ideias.
All the things, even the human relations, are described in terms of only ideas.
Ideias que às vezes acabam não se relacionando com a realidade vivida da experiência.
Many of these ideas are ideas that are not connected to real life.
Então, o pensamento hebraico, contraposto ao pensamento grego, ele tem uma fonte de conhecimento na atividade.
So, in opposition to the Hebrew to the Greek thought, the Hebrew thought has a foundation in
atividade,
in practical actions, practical activities.
Enquanto a fonte do conhecimento no pensamento grego é na contemplação, no pensamento.
But in the other side, the Greek thought has a source of knowledge in the contemplation, in the philosophical ideas.
Os hebreus descreviam as coisas por sua utilidade.
The Hebrew people, they describe the things based on how useful they were, the utility.
Por exemplo, uma caneta, ela serve para escrever.
For example, what is a pen? It's something that you use to write.
Já os gregos escreviam as coisas pela aparência.
But the Greek, they describe things by how they look.
Eles vão olhar para a caneta e falar assim, é um cilindro comprido.
So, a pen for the Greek in the Greek thought will be is a cylinder that has a color that is round.
Eles se preocupam com a forma das coisas.
So they are concerned about the form, the shape, how it looks, not the essence of what is it made for.
O tempo no pensamento hebraico, ele é linear, ele parte de um ponto e vai até continuamente para outra direção.
In the Hebrew thought, time is linear, so it starts in one point and keeps going forever.
Nós estamos vivendo a história do pecado.
We are living the period of history, the period of sin. We are living the history of sin now.
Mas essa história ela vai ser resolvida.
But this stage of this part of the history will be resolved.
E
God will provide a solution.
E as coisas não vão se repetir.
And the sin, all the problem, all the things that are happening now, they will not be repeated again.
Já para os gregos, o tempo e a história são cíclicos.
But for the Greek thoughts, for the Greek people, history is and the stories are cyclical. They always repeat.
Passamos again. Por períodos que se repetem.
We always go through periods that are repeated.
O pensamento hebraico, ele é teocêntrico. Deus é o centro.
The Hebrew thought is theocentrical.
Já no pensamento grego, é o homem que é o centro.
But in the Greek thought, man, humankind is at the center.
Os hebreus, eles prezam pela integridade das coisas.
The Hebrew people in the Hebrew thoughts they are focused on the integrity of the things.
Por exemplo, o homem. O homem ele é um ser material.
For example, the man is a material being.
Mas ele tem a sua mente.
But the man has also its mind, his mind.
O fôlego de vida.
The breath of life.
E quando ele morre, a alma morre junto. É uma coisa só. O homem deixa de existir. Se acaba.
And when the man dies, it's so that its whole being doesn't exist anymore.
Já o pensamento grego é dicotômico.
But in the Hebrew thoughts, there is dichotomy.
As coisas são separadas.
In the Greek thought, there is dichotomy. Things are separated.
As coisas são separadas.
Já falei.
Quando o homem morre, por exemplo,
for example, when man dies, in the Greek thought,
há uma separação.
There is a separation
entre o corpo e a alma.
Between the body and soul.
Isso teve uma influência no cristianismo.
And it performs some influence. There is a role on influencing Christianism.
Na própria teologia católica.
For example, in the Catholic theology itself was influenced.
Que bebeu da filosofia de Platão.
So because Catholic theology drank from Plato's philosophy.
Os hebreus, eles também viviam de um modo espiritual.
So the lifestyle of the Hebrew people was spiritual.
Eles pensavam em tudo o que faziam da sua relação para com Deus.
In everything, in all the relations, everything they were doing in their lives was connected to their relation with God. Was connected to God.
E do desenvolvimento próprio, que era consequência dessa relação.
And also other things going on in their lives were not only connected to God, but also were about their development, growing process that was a consequence of this connection with God.
Já os gregos, eles tinham muitas crenças místicas.
But the Greek people, they have many mystical, occult beliefs.
E então, no pensamento hebraico, Deus é único e soberano.
So in the Greek thought, God was the only sovereign.
Enquanto no pensamento grego havia muitos deuses concorrentes.
But in the Greek thought there were many competing gods.
Então a igreja cristã católica durante muitos anos, por mais de um milênio.
So throughout a period of over 1,000 years, the Catholic Christian Church, the Christian Catholic Church,
cultivou um tipo de educação baseada na cultura grega.
This church, throughout a period of over 1,000 years, they cultivate a educational system that was based in this Greek thought.
Cultivou diversos ensinamentos bíblicos dentro dessa forma grega de pensar.
And even the biblical teachings were cultivated and understood inside of these Greek thoughts.
Tivemos a Reforma Protestante.
Then
depois,
we have the Protestant Reformation.
E os principais reformadores, como Lutero e Melanchthon.
And some of the main reformers like Luther, Martin Luther and Melanchthon.
Compreenderam que era impossível continuar reformas sem dar uma atenção especial à educação cristã.
They understood that it was impossible to continue the Reformation, to progress with the Reformation movement,
então,
without taking care of education, addressing the topic of education.
Então eles construíram as primeiras escolas, os primeiros colégios.
So they built the first schools and the first seminários
e começaram a trabalhar a educação do povo.
And then they start to educate the population, the people.
A intenção era ensinar o povo a ler a Bíblia.
The purpose was to teach the people how to read the Bible.
Eles ensinavam a justificação pela fé.
They were teaching the justification by faith.
E ensinavam também o livre-arbítrio.
They also thought about free will.
Sobre a liberdade de pensar e decidir por si mesmo.
So they taught people how to think by themselves and decide by themselves.
Entendiam que todos tinham direito a ter acesso à palavra de Deus.
They understood that everyone had the right to have access to the Word of God.
Estudá-la.
And study the Bible.
E não depender de uma autoridade humana.
And that they should not depend upon a human authority.
Para intermediar a sua relação com Deus.
To be the mediator between them and God.
Acreditavam e trabalharam pela construção de um modelo de educação para todos.
They believed and they worked for building an educational model that was for all.
Até então, a educação era reservada apenas a algumas poucas pessoas.
Until that time, the education was reserved for only a few people.
Especialmente os líderes religiosos.
Especially for it was reserved only for a few people, especially religious leaders.
Então eles defendiam que tantos meninos quanto meninas, pobres e ricos tinham direito a estudar.
But Martin Luther, Melanchthon and other reformers, they defended the idea that poor and rich, boys and girls, all had the right to have access to education.
E vinham à educação também com um propósito missionário.
And they also saw education as with a missionary purpose.
Tinham a intenção de preparar o povo para expandir o reino de Deus.
They have a plan that was to prepare people to expand the kingdom of God.
Pode ler essa citação.
Sorry for the conversion here.
Vemos uma citação no livro Estudos sobre Educação Cristã.
I'm going to read a quote from the book Studies in Christian Education by Sutherland, that is one of the founders of Andrews University. Mm-hmm. And the quote from his book is the following. The success of the reformers had been due to their control of the young people through their educational system. The papal schools were almost forsaken during the activity of Luther and Melanchthon. But when these reformers died and their successors became more interested in abstract theology than in Christian education, the papacy realized that existence of the papal church itself depended upon a victory over Protestant schools. We are surprised at the skill and the tact the papal educators used in their attack and their rapidity with which they gained the victory.
Então podemos ver que quando os primeiros protestantes morreram,
so we can see that the first generation of Protestants died.
Os protestantes que ficaram,
the Protestants that continued their successors,
começaram a perder o foco.
They start to lose the focus.
E começaram a ter interesse por coisas abstratas.
They start to have interest in things that were abstract.
Inclusive conceitos teológicos abstratos.
And that included also theological abstract concepts.
E foi nesse momento da Reforma Protestante que nasce a Companhia de Jesus.
And by this time of the Reformation is when is born the Society of Jesus, that are the Jesuits.
E eles começam uma luta para ganhar fiéis.
And they start a battle to get followers.
E fundam os colégios jesuítas.
And then they founded the Jesuit schools.
Pode ler a citação.
So the citation from the same book is the following. The Order of the Jesuits found its special mission in combining the Reformation, in combating the Reformation, as the most effective means of arresting the progress of Protestantism. It aimed at controlling education.
Então nós temos instaurados um movimento de contra-reforma.
And then we have the establishment of the counter-reformation movement.
E há muitas coisas interessantes que nós podemos estudar na educação jesuíta.
And there are many interesting things that we can study in the Jesuit educational system.
Inclusive, essa educação construiu o legado educacional que temos hoje na sociedade.
And also this educational system has its legacy even in our modern educational system.
Por exemplo, aqui eu listei algumas das principais características dessa educação.
For example, here I list some of the characteristics of the Jesuit educational system.
O que podemos ver presente num documento que era chamado de Ratio Studiorum.
And these elements we can see in a document they have that is called Ratio Studiorum.
Que era um projeto político-pedagógico das escolas.
That was a political pedagogical project for the schools.
Que dominou por essas escolas por mais de 300 anos.
And that was ruling their schools over a period of 3 centuries.
Com poucas modificações ao longo dos anos.
With just a few peoples throughout this period of time.
Se havia uma escola jesuíta no Brasil e outra em Portugal ou na França.
If there was a Jesuit school in Brazil or Portugal or France.
Todas seguiam o mesmo projeto político-pedagógico.
All of them have to follow this political, pedagogical, educational project.
Primeiro, o currículo ele era rígido e centralizado.
For example, first, the curriculum was rigid and centralized.
Não considerava as necessidades especiais dos alunos nem da sociedade.
It didn't consider the individual needs of the students or the needs of the society.
Havia um foco excessivo nas disciplinas clássicas.
There was an excessive focus on classical disciplines.
Especialmente as disciplinas de retórica e filosofia escolástica.
Especially focus was given to rhetoric and scholastic philosophy.
Negligenciando aquelas disciplinas que têm a ver com as necessidades mais práticas da vida, do mundo real.
And in detriment of disciplines that were more practical and relevant for areas of the real world, real life.
Havia uma ênfase muito grande e excessiva na memorização e na repetição.
There was a big emphasis on memorization and repetition.
O que dificultava nos alunos o exercício do pensamento reflexivo.
And that made difficult for the students to exercise reflective thoughts.
Para uma compreensão profunda do conteúdo.
For a deeper understanding of the content.
Para a resolução de problemas da vida real.
And for solving, and so it also bring problems difficult for solving problems in real life.
A abordagem era muito passiva em relação ao aprendizado.
The approach was very passive with respect to learning.
O professor passava as informações.
The teacher was transmitting information
unidirecionalmente.
Only one way.
E o aluno tinha que decorar, repetir e responder exatamente o que o professor
and
queria.
And the students have to memorize and repeat exactly what the teachers want them to say.
O engajamento ativo do aluno não tinha lugar.
The involvement, the interactivity of the interaction with the student had no space.
Não havia
no room on this.
Havia uma falta de adaptação à diversidade dos alunos.
There was a lack of adaptation to the student diversity that existed.
Porque as pessoas têm diferentes capacidades, estilos de aprendizado.
Because people had different skills and capabilities, different ways to learn.
As pessoas têm diferentes interesses e necessidades.
People have different interests also and also different needs.
E isso não era considerado no currículo.
But it was not taken into consideration in this curriculum.
Havia uma ênfase também excessiva na competição.
And there was a immense, a great, a big emphasis in competition.
A competição foi inventada então como método pedagógico.
So competition was then introduced as a pedagogical educational method.
Eles criavam premiações para distinguir e separar os melhores alunos.
They create awards, prizes to distinguish the some students from others.
Evidenciavam as notas dos alunos, classificavam esses alunos pelas notas.
They were highlighting a few students by their performance grades,
isso,
and separating them, isso, highlighting some.
Isso criava um ambiente de extrema pressão.
And this created an environment of pressure, with a lot of pressure.
O que inclusive afetava o bem-estar emocional dos estudantes.
That was also, of course, affecting the emotional health of the students.
Além de tudo isso, o trabalho prático e útil, ele não teve lugar e era substituído por jogos.
So, and beyond that, the practical useful work had no space and it was replaced by games, competitive games.
Então, como vimos, havia uma falta de integração de habilidades práticas.
So, as we could see, there was a lack of integration of useful skills.
Os alunos, eles eram no máximo, muitas vezes, eles aprendiam a falar sobre as coisas, mas não fazer essas coisas.
So the students, many times, they were taught how to speak about things, but never experienced these things.
Os alunos não eram preparados para os desafios cotidianos da vida.
They were not prepared for the daily life challenges.
A abordagem era dogmática e religiosa.
The approach was very dogmatic and was very religious and dogmatic.
Porque não havia um espaço para tentar compreender e questionar, inclusive, as dúvidas sobre o ensino religioso.
Because there was no space to question the teachings that they were receiving, the doubts they could have. There was no space to question these
things. Os alunos tinham que aceitar o ensino porque vinha de uma autoridade.
They have to accept the teaching because it was coming from someone else's authority.
Autoridade seja o professor ou o papa ou o padre.
That authority could be the teacher, the priest, the pope.
E esse ensino também ele excluía as mulheres.
In this educational system, also the women had no space. They were excluded.
E ele enfatizava a obediência, então, na autoridade. O que dificultava o pensamento independente e crítico dos alunos.
And there was also an emphasis in obedience to authority, what made difficult the development of independent critical thinking among the students.
Essas informações vocês podem ter acesso em qualquer livro de história da educação.
These types of information you can have access in any book about history of education.
Temos então algumas diferenças principais desse modelo de escola com o modelo da educação cristã protestante.
And we have also a list of the main differences of this educational system with the Christian Protestant educational system.
As escolas
Protestant Christian education.
As escolas protestantes quando surgiram?
The Protestant schools when they started?
Nas mãos de Lutero?
In the hands of Luther, Martin Luther?
Ou de alguns dos protestantes que foram para os Estados Unidos?
Or in the hands of some of the Protestants that went to the United States?
Elas seguiam alguns princípios interessantes.
They were following some interesting principles.
Em comparação com essa educação cristã católica, que era baseada na o ensino era baseado na memorização.
If you compare this with the Catholic educational system that was based in memorization.
O ensino, a princípio, nas escolas protestantes eram baseados na prática.
In principle, the teachings in the Protestant schools was based in practice rather than memorization.
Havia um trabalho com a individualidade dos alunos.
There was some emphasis on the individuality of each student.
E o desenvolvimento integral desses alunos.
And there was also an emphasis on the whole development of the students.
Não apenas das capacidades receptivas e reprodutivas.
So the focus was not only in the receptive and reproductive capabilities of the students.
Havia uma ênfase no trabalho intelectual e físico para utilidade na vida.
There was a emphasis there was encouragement for the intellectual and physical work that was useful in life.
E não apenas em um trabalho intelectual e um ofício mecânico.
And so the emphasis was different from the other system that had an emphasis only intellectual and mechanical reproduction.
Inclusive, pela educação protestante, houve uma expansão da investigação na natureza.
And also because of the influence of the work of the Protestant system, there was an increase of the investigation of nature.
Essas escolas privilegiavam também disciplinas que estudavam a natureza.
And these schools, the Protestant schools, they gave more opportunities. They have more focus. They were giving more focus in disciplines that were addressing topics regarding studying nature.
Enquanto as escolas cristãs católicas privilegiavam um currículo mais clássico. Privilegiavam o trabalho com os clássicos filosóficos.
In the other side, the Catholic schools, they were giving more focus in the analysis and investigation of the classic books, the classical authors. They were more focused in philosophy, classic philosophy, philosophical classic, like the eruditism. Eruditeness.
Então a tradição ela fundamentava, ela era uma autoridade para as escolas católicas.
So, in one side, tradition was the authority in the Catholic schools.
Enquanto para as escolas protestantes era a revelação, a Bíblia.
Meanwhile, in the Protestant schools, the authority was the Bible.
Um parâmetro para a identificação da verdade.
The parameter that allow us to identify truth.
As escolas protestantes, então, elas exaltavam o evangelho como uma solução para os problemas do mundo.
The Protestant schools, they exalted the gospel as the source for the solution of the problems of the world.
Enquanto as escolas católicas, baseadas no pensamento grego e romano, exaltavam os caminhos humanos.
In the other side, the Catholic schools were exalting the human ways as a way to solve the problems.
As escolas protestantes trabalhavam então a autonomia do pensamento e não a massificação de alunos.
The Protestant schools were then working, dealing with the autonomy, promoting the autonomy of the thinking, and not give an approach that was focusing on massification of the knowledge.
Trabalhavam a descentralização do poder.
They also were working towards the decentralization of power.
O que temos como resultado na organização dos Estados Unidos a democracia moderna.
And one of the results was the organization of the United States of America, that is the birth of modern democracy.
É um assunto muito interessante para a gente estudar em um outro momento.
It's a topic that is very important, is very interesting to be addressing in a future study here.
E o currículo ele era aberto, sujeito às necessidades, escolhas dos alunos e necessidades sociais também.
The curriculum was open because it was adaptable for the needs and interests of the students in their social context.
Achei interessante mencionar aqui um exemplo, essa abordagem, essa notícia sobre o Papa.
I think it's important to address here this statement that the Pope made.
Que quando nós pensamos em uma educação cristã,
because when we think about Christian education,
nós pensamos na Bíblia.
We think about Bible.
E se a gente está falando de criacionismo,
and if we're talking about creation,
estamos falando da Bíblia.
We're talking about Bible.
E aqui o Papa, ele faz uma declaração que ele admite a evolução.
And here Pope Francis, he declares that he accepts evolution.
Ele diz que a evolução, ela é real para Deus.
And he states that evolution is real for God.
E Deus não é um mágico.
And God is not a magician, a wizard.
Então, como que a gente consegue, vocês conseguem pensar na conciliação entre uma educação baseada na visão criacionista, numa visão evolucionista com cristã?
So, in this sense, are you able to harmonize an educational system that is based in the Bible, that is Christian, and at the same time is evolutionist?
Para conciliar os dois?
Is it possible to harmonize both systems?
Hoje em dia, o evolucionismo, ele se infiltrou em todas as áreas de conhecimento.
So today evolutionism vision infiltrated in all areas of knowledge.
Desde quando a gente entra na universidade, seja em qual área for.
Since the beginning when we start university, whatever area it is,
seja na biologia ou na matemática,
can be in biology, history,
na
mathematics,
história, na psicologia,
sociologia, sociology,
todas as áreas de conhecimento são fundamentadas numa cosmovisão evolucionista.
All these areas have some influence of evolutionism.
E nós vemos que os protestantes se afastaram do ideal de Deus também.
And we can see also that even the Protestants, they depart from God's ideals for them.
Nós muitas vezes temos perdido oportunidade.
Many times we have lost opportunities.
De fazer diferença nesse mundo.
Of make difference in this world.
Construir conhecimento baseado na palavra de Deus.
And build knowledge based in God's word.
E apresentá-lo ao mundo.
And present it to the world.
Vejam o que diz essa citação.
See, for example, what is in this quote by Sutherland again. A brief survey of the history of the Protestant denomination shows that the spiritual downfall in 1844 was the result of their failure to understand the true science of education. They failed to understand and to practice Christian education, unfitted then to proclaim to the world the message of Christ's second coming. The Seventh-day Adventist denomination was then called into existence to take up the work which the popular churches had failed to train their missionaries to do. The Protestant denomination could not give the third angel's message, a reform movement, which is a warning against the beast and his image, because they were still clinging to those doctrines and those principles of education, which themselves form the beast and his image.
A pessoa que escreveu essa citação,
the person that wrote this citation,
Edward Sutherland, ele era pioneiro da educação adventista.
He was a pioneer in the Seventh-day Adventist education.
E ele menciona que as igrejas protestantes, elas falharam em reconhecer a mensagem espiritual de 1844.
And he states that the Protestant churches, they failed to recognize the message in 1844.
E essa derrota, ela tem a ver com a abertura.
And this defeat that they receive, it has to do with the openness they had.
E o descuido.
And the lack of attention, lack of being aware.
Das escolas protestantes.
Descuido das escolas protestantes.
Esse descuido e essa falha tem a ver com o descuido das escolas protestantes.
So, the defeats the Protestants received had was because of the lack of preparation and not being aware in their educational system.
Ao se abrirem para as tradições e o currículo medieval.
And it happened because they opened themselves to tradition and to the medieval curriculum from the Jesuits.
Então, depois de 1844, Deus levanta uma igreja especial.
So after 1844, God calls a church.
E ele dá uma
into existence.
Missão especial.
And he gives a special mission to this church.
A mensagem dos três anjos.
And this message is known as the Three Angels message.
Ele diz: vi outro anjo voar pelo meio do céu.
And we know, and I saw another angel fly in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel to preach unto them that dwell on the earth, and to every nation, and kindred, and tongue, and people, saying with a loud voice, fear God and give glory to him, for the hour of his judgment is come. And worship him that made heaven, and earth, and the sea, and the fountains of waters.
Então nós temos uma mensagem especial.
So we have a special message.
Que é chamar o povo para a adoração do verdadeiro Deus.
That is to call God, people back to worship the true God.
Esse Deus está sendo esquecido no meio de tantas filosofias humanas.
This God is being forsaken and forgotten in the midst of so many human ideas.
Em breve vai haver um juízo.
Soon there will be judgment.
Assim como houve nos dias do dilúvio.
And that happened in the time of Noah, during the period of the flood, before the flood.
E a nossa única esperança.
And our only hope.
É voltar a nossa adoração para aquele que fez o céu, a terra, o mar e as fontes das águas.
And our only hope is to bring and turn our minds and hearts back to the one that is the creator of the heaven, the earth and the springs of water.
Nós precisamos estudar sobre isso.
We need to study about these things.
E pregar sobre isso.
And preach about these things.
E isso envolve educação.
And it is what is involved in education message.
Vejam o que Ellen White diz.
Please pay attention to what Ellen G. White says about that. Now as never before, we need to understand the true science of education. If we fail to understand this, we shall never have a place in the kingdom of God. The science of true education is the truth. The third angel's message is truth.
Então, nós temos uma missão especial na área da educação e as três mensagens angélicas são a base da nossa identidade como adventistas e criacionistas.
Again.
So
we have a special mission in the area of education.
E as três mensagens angélicas.
And the three angels' message.
São pontos especiais.
Are special key points.
Que fundamentam a nossa identidade.
That provide the foundation for our identity.
Como adventistas e criacionistas.
As Seventh-day Adventists and creationists.
Vocês podem ler sobre esse conteúdo nesses dois livros, especialmente.
You can read about this type of this content in these two books. They are
Grande Controvérsia.
The Great Controversy by Ellen G. White.
Estudos em Educação Cristã.
And Studies in Christian Education by Edward Sutherland.
Inclusive os dois nós temos acesso na internet.
Both are freely available in PDF on internet, but you can also contact publishing houses or find them the physical books as well.
Vamos orar?
Let's pray. Let's stand up. And pray. Let's pray. The Heavenly Father, we are living the last moments of this planet. There's a spiritual war. Both sides have their strategies to prepare its allies to the final controversy. You have your educational system. Satan has its alternative to prepare his people to fight against your church, against your message. So help us to understand the importance of education, the true education that is based in the principles that are established in the Bible, that are established in the spirit of prophecy through the teachings of, through these writings of Ellen G. White, and also that are established and can be found in the study of science, nature. That is also another book that, according to Romans, you left us to learn about you. Help us to give credit to the right sources instead of the human tradition, the human philosophy that can contribute some aspects, but in many moments is influenced by Satan to take the authority from you, God, to the creatures, to him, to other human beings, whatever it is. But we know the only authority that we should bow down to is the authority of you, our God. So we ask you to help us to develop in our lives this education, and also to develop and teach others how to develop in their lives the principles that will enable us to finish the mission we are given, but that until now we have failed to proclaim. Forgive us and help us to reestablish the altar where we should worship you, as Elijah in his time established the true worship. Now, as the third Elijah, we should do the same in the spirit of apostasy and separation of the word from you. But help us to be the messengers that will bring back the hearts of children to their fathers, so that they will recognize that you are the only sovereign of the universe and the only one that is worth of being worshipped and loved and followed. And we understand that through the true message of education, that is preparing the whole life, the mind and the practical skills to stand and live forever with you in the heaven. Be with us, be with the church, be with your children all around the world, and be with all those sincere people that don't know the truth yet. Prepare their hearts and minds to receive the message when is appropriate time. Stay with us. We thank you for the blessings and for the privilege of knowing these things, because we don't deserve them, but we thank for all these things, and we thank in the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior, and only authority. Amen.